Hello, I'm Lisa Altman-Hall, the Professor and Chair of Systems Design Engineering at the University of Waterloo. Thank you so much for joining us at the University of Waterloo's Fall Open House. Our department has two great programs, Systems Design Engineering and Biomedical Engineering. And today I'm introducing Systems Design Engineering, a truly unique interdisciplinary engineering program. We apply engineering methods to solve real-world complex problems, everything from very, very small nanoscale to the very large global scale. I study complex transportation systems. I'm interested in understanding how to model long-distance inner-city travel so we can adjust where we use airplanes, trains, cars, and even telecommunications so that we can maximize community benefits, community access, while minimizing carbon and air toxic emissions. I also study where and when we should plug in our electric vehicles in order to minimize emissions from the electric power sector. I'm so very proud of the way our cohort-based program creates a welcoming and supportive community. We will prepare you for success after graduation. In some cases, you'll have success with a focus that you couldn't even have imagined when you started your engineering program. When I started studying engineering, I thought I would be designing buildings, not studying travel, but I love studying travel. In today's session, I'll answer some of your questions about systems design engineering. First, what is systems design engineering? Why might you be interested in studying this field? I'll share what you'll learn in our program, a little bit about our facilities at Waterloo, the campus, student life, our co-op programs, and highlight a couple of examples of career opportunities from our graduates. Many of our alumni are still active in supporting our current Waterloo systems design engineering. So what is systems design engineering? It's a common question we get. We ask ourselves all the time. You have to first think about systems. The world is made up of all these interconnected systems that work together. And the elements of that system, every system, have a purpose. They have a way they operate. They're integral to the overall outcome of the big picture system. And you have to design not just the individual elements, but actually how those elements work together. We want to have optimum output designed from our overall system. So you have to design that. And you have to design in a structured way that engages stakeholders so that they can have meaningful input while we as engineers all worry about the technical design. And engineering, of course, is the application of science and math to solve problems. So when you put these three things together, systems, design, and engineering, you get systems design engineering. So there's many, many examples. These are some of the examples where our faculty actually work. The human body itself is a system. We offer another program in our department in biomedical engineering that goes into these systems in greater depth. Everything from medical devices to cellular level engineering of tissues. And of course, there's environmental systems that include water resources, like groundwater. And my favorite thing, transportation systems, is in the social environmental systems. Some people call it social technical systems, part of our department. Intelligent systems, of course, is a rapidly growing field. We see it everywhere around us in all industries. And many of our faculty and students, for example, work in robotics, which makes use of tons of intelligent systems. Lastly, human factors is actually where that human and computer interaction come together to achieve a goal. You can think of the cockpit of an airplane, for example, or autonomous vehicles. We have one that drives around our ring road here on campus. So of course, students are all asking themselves, is systems design engineering right for me? It's broad. It contains the core technical engineering skills that you'll need for real world problem solving. We often hear that systems design engineering alumni chose our program because they knew they wanted to be an engineer. They wanted to be a designer, a problem solver, but they wanted to keep their options open, the particular application that they might work on in their career path. And that's exactly what systems design engineering offers, a really solid technical engineering education with the flexibility to sort of create your own specializations, in particular, right off in the program with the electives you choose. So there's often no single right answer to a systems design. And in the same way, there's no single right way to do the systems design engineering curriculum at the University of Waterloo. It's great for those who think outside the box, who enjoy taking calculated risks, who maybe, don't know what the solution would be, but see that there's a problem that we need to solve in our global society. What will you learn? Well, the first thing to sort of know about the University of Waterloo Systems Design Engineering Program is that it is an accredited engineering program. It's a Bachelor of Applied Science. You will be able to register to become a professional engineer in Ontario or other jurisdictions of Canada. It has the core technical education that comes from the traditional engineering disciplines, mechanical, electrical, civil, and others, but it has this systems focus. We have a lot of hands-on labs, a lot of workshop courses, a lot of design courses, and we have 10 elective spaces where you can take options from all over campus. They don't need to be options in our department. There's lots of other ways that you learn other than traditional courses and homeworks and exams. What you see here in this picture is actually from our first year design days this year, fall 2022. Students had to build a parachute that would protect an iPhone from a one-story fall. And if I remember correctly, we didn't have any iPhone injuries this fall at all. All of this design leads up to the capstone design project in fourth year, where you work with a team to conceptualize, understand the problem, and then design a solution to it. And you may practice your design skills all through the program with design teams and clubs, and a number of our students go on international exchange. So this is a crazy busy slide, but it's a way to think about the curriculum and then the five-year experience. So you go from left to right, you see our 8 academic terms with the 6 co-op terms worked in yellow. And there's design courses that we have towards the top of this slide. And then as you move down, the engineering, math, and science courses and the elective courses, and you see as you move from first year to the 4A and 4B terms, the number of electives really increase in number. And by alternating the academic and work terms, as all of the engineering programs do at Waterloo, you sort of learn in the workplace. And you sort of take stuff you learned in the classroom and you bring those lessons back to the classroom. There's a lot of information on this slide, but I think one of the things to take from this is it's really robust and a really interdisciplinary engineering education with design just simply sprinkled all through. So what is design? You might be saying, what's she talking about? What's design? What's a design course? Well, in a design course, you'll have open-ended assignments or projects. And so you might build something, but like the parachute. But another example is my students in my fall class right now have just completed an assignment where they've developed a preliminary framework to model the external costs, such as carbon emissions, in the industry of their choice. Perhaps it was mining or nuclear energy, but there was no right answer. They had to develop a framework, and there were many right answers. I've worked at 4 universities in my career, and I just cannot emphasize how great the faculty and staff of the systems design engineering departments are. Our advisors right down the hall from my office support students in all aspects of their academic career. And more importantly, these designers that we have right here in the department with us link you to the many on-campus resources. I mean, Waterloo is a big university. There's a lot of resources. And when you don't know where to find them, you ask in the systems design engineering hallway on the 6th floor of V5. And we guide you to those on-campus resources. Labs and workshop courses are taught by technical instructors. Our growing list of faculty teach our core and specialized courses. They also have research groups. Some of our undergrads choose to do research in those research groups. Just this year, we added 6 new professors. They study sustainable energy systems, modeling natural disaster recovery, social robotics. The picture you see here is actually one of our new faculty members from this summer, the Schlegel Research Chair in Technology for Healthy Aging. It's Professor Cosmin Montano. And his research focuses on how older adults interact with technology. So where are you going to study if you come join us here in Systems Design Engineering at Waterloo? We have classrooms, labs, and study spaces. They're in the newest buildings on campus, E5 and E7. Again, I'm a little bit of a transportation geek. My favorite thing about these buildings is we have our very own light rail station right outside my office window. You see here in the picture, our prototyping lab. It was revamped in 2020 with the very generous support of some of our department's alumni. Students have access to workshop spaces to work on their projects. In all of these rooms, including the room you see pictured, we have lockers where students store the projects that they're working on. If they happen to be a physical system, physical systems and non-physical systems, both. The non-physical systems, of course, don't need a workshop locker. There's access to the den, which has equipment and materials that you can use to build projects. We have our own maker space, as well as the Faculty of Engineering's maker space. Ours has 3D printing and laser cutting right here in E5. Our cohort-based program means that you will take courses with a group of about 100 students. That may seem like a lot, but I'm always really appreciate how the students know each other, how the faculty know each of these cohorts. Each cohort has its own unique character. They support each other, get to know each other, because they're basically always together in a classroom and moving through the whole program. I think it's a real strength. What you see here in the pictures is actually on the left-hand side, design days. The first-year students at the start of September working on design tasks together. And then on the right-hand side, you see our graduating class last spring celebrating at the end of our program with the black tie. And both of these pictures are actually in our E5 and E7 facilities. So systems design engineering, like the other engineering programs, is a mandatory cooperative education. Over the course of the program, you're going to go away for 2 years of total paid work. We have really, really good employment rates in our program. 98% of our students this fall were employed. Co-op really gives you an opportunity to try out different roles, different workplaces, different industries. I often hear students sort of say to me when I ask them, how was your co-op? They'll say it was really great, but next time I think I'm going to try this other type of industry. And it's really a chance to do that. And then there's other students who spend all of their co-ops, sometimes in the same industry or the same company. And they're all over the place, across Canada and beyond, the United States and even beyond. So there's sort of unlimited potential because of the diversity of this broad field. We find that our graduates are in many different career paths all over the world. Many of them are entrepreneurs. Some of them turned their capstone fourth year design projects into a business. They took full advantage of Waterloo's entrepreneurship resources. You see Hannah pictured here, who did a social impact incubator with her St. Paul's University College partnered capstone project. Other people pursue further education. They go to graduate school, like you see here, one of our graduate students with a robotic exoskeleton assistive device in the McPhee lab. Other alumni combine side with other professions such as business, law, or medicine. Some work in the governmental sector or the non-governmental organizations. It's really a place where you can invent an engineering career that suits you. So I want to leave you with that message that systems design engineering is a unique program. It's a great community environment. I think it provides you with that solid base you need to go out and do potentially complex problem solving that we don't even know exists today, to be ready to apply your technical skills to solve those problems. I thank you so much for considering Waterloo and the Systems Design Engineering Program. If you want to know more about us, you can check out our website. And you can also check us out on social media. Thank you so much for joining us at this open house. Take care and goodbye for now.